Think of me fondly when we've said goodbye. Remember me once in a while. Please promise me you'll try. When you find that once again you long to take your heart back and be free. If you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me.
You're tuned to the Jordan Rich Show here on WBZ and WCCO, and that voice is very, very special and more recognizable as every day moves through. It, of course, is the voice of Jackie Evancho, who made the country take notice when she appeared on America's Got Talent and just blew everybody away. And she's got a brand new album that this song, Think of Me, is featured on. It's called Awakening, and she's going to be appearing in Boston at Symphony Hall on October 23rd, 8 p.m., and I'll tell you how you can get tickets early. Jackie, a real pleasure to welcome you to our radio show here. Nice to have you on board.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
First of all, your story is just so cool. And I mean, you're living a dream, but you're also somebody who's very accomplished. Many people wonder where this voice comes from and what kind of training you've had to sound so mature and so developed here with your voice.
I've never really had training. In all honesty, I've tried very hard to find a coach or just a vocal teacher that didn't try to steer my voice in the wrong direction, but we never really could find anyone like that. So it was just me and my mom. It's still me and my mom. And every once in a while, we'll go and get a little checkup to make sure I'm not developing any bad habits.
Yeah, so it's you and your mom. Is your mom also a fine singer?
No, I'm actually the only singer in my family, but my whole family is very musical.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess it just had to add up a bit to get to singing.
I'm talking to a young lady, and I believe you're 14 now, is that right?
15.
I'm so sorry. Never get a woman's age wrong like that. That's very embarrassing. But at 15, you have so much poise and stage presence and all that. Your voice is one thing, but to get out in front of a national audience or to do a tour like the one you're doing, you know, it requires inner confidence and all that. Who do you attribute that to? Your mom and family as well?
I definitely do. My whole family is really unique, and we all have this sense of maturity at a young age, and I'm very thankful for that because it definitely was in my favor. And it's just the way my parents raised me to make sure that I had manners and that I was polite, and I definitely agreed with what they taught me, so it just stuck.
And I don't have to tell you this, but there are many people who start out at such a high level at a very young age, and if they don't have that kind of parental help along the way, oftentimes they can take a detour. It sounds as though you're very grounded and you know kind of where you're going with your career and with your life.
I get that a lot, and I'm thankful that I do because it lets me know that I'm doing the right thing. I definitely don't want to lose control of myself, and I want to stay the way I am.
I'm talking with Jackie Evancho, who, again, will be appearing in Boston in October on a nationwide... Is it a worldwide tour or a nationwide tour?
I think it's worldwide.
It's okay. It's a lot of places. I know you're very busy. And I'm talking with her about her brand new CD. And this is interesting because, obviously, when you're on national TV for the first time, you're doing something that's, well, just blew everybody away. It was very operatic. But now you're sort of branching out a little bit. And on this CD, there's some really different kinds of things still done with your style. Talk about what's on the CD, because it's some great, great selections.
Thank you. Well, on the album, there are songs that are more Broadway, and then there's songs that are more pop, and songs that are opera arias, so it's kind of everywhere. And what I'm trying to do is just see what my voice can do and experiment with different sounds, but still staying true to my classical crossover voice.
Mm-hmm. Well, you do one thing, track 8 from Game of Thrones, The Reigns of Castamere, and that was really impressive because, I mean, I'm familiar with that sound, but the way you do it is just sort of ethereal and weird and eerie and exciting at the same time.
Thank you.
But the classical element of your voice is still very prominent. So there's, for instance, a version of Ave Maria, which is beautiful, and Je T'aime, which I love, and Vocalise. So you've got a variety of things on here that must have been fun to do.
It was. It was very fun. It can be stressful at times, though, because oftentimes we'll have 4 songs that we sing in one recording session, and it'll be like With or Without You, and then it'll go to vocalese, and my voice is in 2 different places, so I kind of have to warm up to get back in that area.
You're very sweet and very cultured and attractive young lady. What's life like when you're not singing in terms of school, peers, friends, that kind of thing? Are you able to live somewhat of a normal life?
I live a very normal life. I feel like, I mean, oftentimes people will sit there and say, oh, she's got her childhood taken away from her. And I don't think that at all. I think it's just an enhanced childhood because I still have that normal girl aspect. And I think Pittsburgh is a great place to be raised because people understand that. We're kind of all family, sort of. And so I definitely do have a great normal girl aspect to my
life. Good for you. People like David Foster, whom I've interviewed, and Robert Redford, whom I've not, took a shine to you. And you were in a movie already with Redford, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
What? Oh, that's got to be mind-blowing for your first movie experience behind the camera, doing something with that cast in that film. Did you feel you were, well, did they approach you or did you audition for this or what?
They approached me, and as Robert Redford said, he was looking for the role to play his daughter in this movie, and he just could not find anyone. And he was flipping through TV channels, and he found me in my PBS special. And he thought, well, I could probably direct her, so he contacted me, and I sent in a video, and it worked. So
that is so cool. Are you still in touch with any of those people from the Hollywood scene?
Not very often, but we keep each other very fondly with each other.
That's great. You know, voices do change in childhood and puberty and you know, all that kind of thing. My voice, actually, I sounded like this till I was 12, and then I sounded like this. But in your case, your voice is so authentic and so, may I use the word, mature. Have you noticed any changes in your voice in the last, say, 3 years?
I have noticed many changes, but it's never anything bad. It's just easier for me to control my voice and to hit higher notes and lower notes, and it's a benefit for me.
And a couple more things. Broadway. You do a lot of Broadway stuff on this album and beyond. Is this the kind of dream that a little girl from Pittsburgh might have, to not just sing on stage, but sing on a Broadway stage in a Broadway show?
Well, a lot of people ask that, but I have to say no, because what I'm doing now is exactly what I was going for as my dream. But it would be fun every once in a while to do a Phantom of the Opera show.
Well, that's a music that you love. That was inspiring. And of course, one looks at YouTube and the fact that it's just amazingly vast. I think there were 10,000 entries that arrive on YouTube every minute, or some crazy statistic. If it weren't for YouTube, do you think you'd be where you are today on the national scene?
Probably not, because I had tried 2 times to get into America's Got Talent in person. And it was the YouTube special that got me into the show.
And, of course, the YouTube special led to that, which led to this. And you just keep on keeping on, which is great. And you have a terrific, terrific, I think, musical sense to pick the songs you're doing. And when you appear in concert at Symphony Hall, let's say in October, is there who's with you? What kind of musical backup and so forth are you planning on having?
I have a smaller orchestra behind me, and then I have my musical director, Peter Kieswalter, who has a few numbers to himself throughout the show, and he's fantastic. He is such a great person to work with because he understands completely.
That's great, and I know this sounds like an old joke, but you know, how do you get to Symphony Hall? How do you get to Carnegie Hall? Practice. But have you had an opportunity to play some of the other great halls in the country, and what do you think so far?
I have, and I think that it's super fun, and I love traveling everywhere and seeing different places and performing in different places, so I feel like I'm honored to actually have that opportunity, because I know many people don't.
Well, you're going to love Symphony Hall. It's a beautiful, historic, wonderful place, great acoustics, and so many amazing stars over the last 100 years have played there, so why not Jackie? We're going to end our little chat here with more music from the new CD called Awakening by Jackie Evancho, and I thought we would do something that, again, it strikes you as something a little different. A U2 song, With or Without You. Why did you select this one?
I thought it would just be fun to kind of give a shot at it and see how I can perform it.
I love your attitude. Everything you do is, well, might be fun. So that's the way you should. Never change. Please, don't do me a favor, okay? It's Jackie Evancho. Let me mention now how people can get tickets to see her. You can call Symphony Hall box office at 888-266-1200, 888-266-1200. There's also a website, bso.org/seat/select-your-own-performance. You'll see it there. And again, the date is October 23rd, 2015, 8 p.m., and it's part of a world tour of Jackie Evancho, Awakening Live in Concert. Jackie, so nice to meet you, and what's Howard Stern really like?
He's very nice. He's very nice, but he is definitely honest, and many people take that the wrong way.
Well, there you go. I get an honest answer from you every time. Really a pleasure meeting you, and good luck and much more success and happiness along the way.
Thank you. You too.